Kyle, did Mandy ask you to go to New York with her?
Oh, no, I surprised her with that. But we always want to be with each other.
Okay, well, some people think it's a good idea for couples to spend time apart.
Boy, you can find anything on the internet if you look hard enough.
When Mr. Baxter and I got married, he was traveling the world taking pictures for the Outdoor Man catalog.
Yeah, I've seen him. Yeah, he's wrestling that crocodile, or he's got his head in that lion's mouth.
Yeah, well, some of those pictures may have been photoshopped. But the thing is, he never would have been able to do all those things if I was with him.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, yeah.
And he wouldn't have become the inspirational figure he is today. And who would have had driven me to achieve all the great things I've done?
Yeah, well, big loss all around. But Kyle, do you see what I'm getting at?
Not really, but I don't think that's important when you're enjoying a conversation.
You're that dopey grin you always walk around with, huh? This must be bad news.
I'm afraid so. I want to take some time off, which means you won't be seeing me all summer.
Still waiting for the bad news.
I want to go with Mandy to New York.
And there it is.
It's for 10 weeks.
10 weeks?
Yeah, but it won't seem that long because of those New York minutes.
That's 70 nights alone with Mike's daughter in a city that never sleeps.
What if that oven's big enough for Kyle?
Well, it's okay with me if it's okay with Mike.
It's not okay with Mike.
Dad, nothing is going to happen in New York that isn't already happening here in Denver.
Spoken like a teenage mom.
Mr. B, Mandy means the world to me, and I need to know that she's safe.
She's going to be just fine.
If you won't give me the time off, then I'll have to quit. And I know that means that if I ever come back, I'll have to start at the bottom.
You already are at the bottom.
Well, then I should pick up the job quick.
Thinking behind it.
Clearly.
I don't care what the bedroom looks like as long as we're in it together.
Right, right. That's what I was thinking. I think we should take another closer look at it. Just you and me together.
I think you are right. Girls, why don't you go get us some food?
We already got some.
Get some more!
Okay, Kyle, can you drive?
No, I don't think so. I want to take a look at that bedroom. Dangerous. I saw this documentary about this house in Kansas with this girl and her little dog inside that got completely picked up by a tornado. Although, interesting fact, that's where color comes from.
It's swamped. Can you help me out for about a half an hour?
Maybe you should ask Ryan to do it in case zombies attack the restaurant.
I hate that I know what you're talking about. He even made himself a trophy.
He deserves it. He's a genius. Planting crops, fighting bats with balloons. Hey, he saved his family, and I left Mandy out there on her own.
So you can't help me because in a made-up game, your wife was eaten by imaginary zombies?
Hey, I don't want everybody to know. I realize that there's no such thing as zombies. Yet. But there are scary things in the real world. Will I be able to protect Mandy from those?
Kyle, do you know what Mandy's always been afraid of?
Uneven eyebrows? She mentions that a lot.
Her biggest fear was always that she wasn't going to find the right guy to share her life with.
So sad. I know she will.
Wait, no, it's you, Kyle. You're that guy. Do you know how many nights I spent in Mandy's bedroom after a bad date trying to convince her that all guys weren't awful?
I don't know. Four?
Sure. Yeah. And then one night, she told me that she found the guy that made all the dozens... I mean... four guys for him, not matter.
She said that?
Yeah. See? You already saved her. And you will every day for the rest of your life.
Huh. And I didn't even need any stupid balloons. Hey, tell Ryan to enjoy that trophy because it's gonna be mine someday.
It's a G.I. Joe missing both arms glued to a piece of wood.
Is there anything he can't do? Kristen, what are you doing sneaking around this time of year? What if you were Mandy?
Why? Is that her present?
Maybe. Maybe not. But mostly maybe.
Hey, look, I don't know what you have in there, but you know what would be a really great gift for Mandy? Something that would help her be on time.
A bus schedule?
No, something more wristy, watchy.
You mean like a wristwatch?
Hey, yeah, great idea, Kyle. Oh, look, and I found this one in a magazine.
Oh, yeah, Mandy taped one of these to my steering wheel. Yeah, but it's not as nice as what I have for her. It's not the kind of thing you can buy in a store.
So you made her something?
Maybe. Maybe not.
But mostly maybe?
Maybe. I can't wait to see the look on her face when she opens it.
Kyle, you got a sec?
It's gonna be the greatest Christmas ever.
Maybe.
You should set them free, and if they return to you, they're truly yours.
Or maybe they're coming back for revenge because it took you so long to set them free. I was very good at the piano.
Look at that. Another farm accident with a happy ending. Look, nothing will happen.
I don't want to talk about it. She said that all I care about is the store.
I'm sure she didn't mean that. She probably just found somebody she likes better. League softball uniform, Mr. Alzate.
Oh, thank you,
Kyle. Also, there was a weird gas smell coming from your kitchen, so I lit a bunch of scented candles.
I hope we have enough guys to play ball once Howard is no longer with us.
Oh, no.
Yeah, oh, relax. He's moving to Phoenix. Because he's dying.
Hey, Kyle. Is my dad in there?
Yeah. Well, he went in there, but he could have gone out the window. Or disguised himself and walked right past me. Or...
I'll just check.
I had to sign for it and everything.
It's a big boy day for you, huh, Kyle? The Explorer's Museum.
Oh, that's great.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Finally, they want me to submit an artifact.
Oh, and your name would be immortalized with all those famous explorers. Like that guy who found that thing on the mountain. Or that lady who pulled that doohickey from the river.
Their names live on and on, don't they?
Hey, what are you gonna submit?
This 1,000-year-old spearhead I found in the Honduran rainforest. Came from a lost civilization.
Wow, I can't believe they let you take that out of the country.
Well, Honduran's very trusting people. They trust it when you tell them at customs, yeah, I got that at a gift shop. Wait a minute, there's Ed. I gotta show him this.
Oh, he's gonna be really happy for you.
No, he's wanted this forever. It's gonna kill him.
I love that you two like to make each other miserable.
It's called friendship, Kyle. Yeah.
Hey, Mr. Alzate,
yeah.
What's worse, Mr. B getting in the Explorer's Museum or his zingers?
You got invited.
Yeah, that was the news. Look, Ed, sorry, but you know what's gonna happen? You're gonna get in because you're a great, great man.
Oh, direct hit.
I'm very happy for you, Mike. Yes, I am. There's nothing better than seeing a friend receive an honor that you've wanted your entire adult life.
Man, the zingers between you two are getting more and more subtle.